Kevin, it's good to be here with Lacey and his family and all of the legislators and colleagues on the dais here. I was very impressed with everything that I've heard, so much so that I would rather just listen to other people and hear what it is they have to have said. I think Lynn Holton touched upon it in terms of going back and looking back and referencing Albertus Harrison. And I think it was timely that he did so, because as much as we like to talk about some things, it's very difficult to talk about reality and the reality of changing times and things that have changed and things that do change. Lacey came in at a time serving in the House under the iron hand of Blackie Moore. And that transcended into the velvet glove of my good friend John Warren Cook. And then some would call it the wire brush of A.L. Philpott. But all of them, transcending figures among themselves, were involved with being certain that the people of Virginia were served. And when I look back at it and my relationship with Lacey legislatively, and when I was in the office of lieutenant governor as well as governor, it's always been cordial but evolutionary. We all were able to learn from each other and to appreciate each other's views and to why we voted different ways, or sometimes consistently with each other. And I think the biggest tribute that could be paid to Lacey is that he's been that transcending figure in Virginia government to not, as you said, Lynn Holton, continue to look back, but to look ahead, to look forward. Virginia has set so many fine examples for the rest of the nation as to who we are as the founding state of the nation, to send forth the leaders that we've sent forth, so much so that we need not live in the past, but continue to look to the future. And people like Lacey, who blend in orchestration with viewpoints and change and imagination to see that take place, is what makes me feel good. I remember he called me the morning after I was elected, and I was still giddy. Up in the air, and he asked me what I was doing. And I told him I was reading a book. He hadn't gotten over it yet. I remember when I was running for statewide office in Bedford and running through the town and riding on cars and convertibles and beautiful weather and running into him and his beautiful grandchildren, and they all were so cordial with me and to me and saying any numbers of good and nice things. I remember when I was likewise governor, when we first started bringing in packets of legislators, Republicans as well as Democrats, to talk with them about what we had in mind, and Lacey was being among them. Many of them couldn't believe it, said, "What do you mean we are really being consulted?" And I said, "Yes, because this is a we thing, not a me thing. I'm more interested in what we as people do." And I've been fortunate to have known him, to have worked with him, and to call him friend. God bless you, and thank you for being with us.